So it looks like the good weather is here at last in the UK. We can just about call this summer. Although how long that's going to last for, I don't know. In this episode on Dadskillz, I've put together six basic DIY tools that I think are a must-have to undertake any task around the house. So whether you're new to DIY, this is your first project you're thinking about, or you've done it in the past and you think it's time to take on something a little bigger, I've put together a list of six tools that I think are the must-haves for any project. So let's take a look. Yes, so welcome back to Dadskillz. If you're new to the channel, you've not seen any of my content before, I've done a lot of DIY tasks that you too can undertake, and I've shown you step by step how I do those and how I undertake them and the thinking behind what I do. And through my work as a tradesman in the UK, I've accumulated a lot of very useful tools that help me to help you undertake your DIY project. And after spending a while thinking about what the basic tools are, I've put together six that I think you'll need if you're about to undertake a simple DIY project at home. So let's take a look. We're going to start at the cheapest, and I'm going to go through to the most expensive. I've linked everything that I think is a good buy below. It certainly won't be the cheapest, and it certainly won't be the most expensive. It would just be good quality tools that I think will last until you decide to move on to, say, a bigger project and you decide to invest a bit more in your tooling.
Ah!
So let's take a look at the first one. And the first one is dead easy. And this one is my Dewalt tape measure. I've got three or four. I always have a few lying around the place, in the van, at home, because they're bound to go missing. People borrow these things and walk off with them accidentally. What makes a tape measure cheap and expensive generally is how long you can put them out for before they click and fall over. So if you've got no one helping you, you want to be able to get this out as long as you can across the room, extended without breaking. So this one was quite an expensive one. This one, geez, I can get this out to like 13 foot or something before this breaks, is brilliant. I'll put the details of the tape measure. I think it's a good quality tape measure. I'll put the Amazon link below so you can get that should you need that. But this is basic stuff. Measuring is like the fundamentals of doing DIY.
Ah!
So next, number two. What I think is the basics. DIY basics. A good set of screwdrivers. These are very basic. These are Stanley. These are things that I would use at home. I wouldn't use them for my job. Because I'm an electrician, so I need insulated screwdrivers. But for this example, you won't need that because you're not an electrician, and obviously you won't be touching electrics in the UK. But Stanley, well-known make, good enough quality for what you're going to do around the house. And if you're taking on that first DIY project, you might use this, I don't know, a couple of times a year, that's it. So they're going to be fine. So I'll link again. Number two, my pick for number two, screwdriver set, basic screwdriver set. I'll link that down below. So number three, pliers. Now, these pliers that I use again for my job, insulated to 1,000 volts. You won't need anything this expensive, but pliers, you can cut with them in there. So that's useful. And then obviously you can grip something in here, pulling, gripping, turning, tightening, loosening, pliers. That's my pick for number three.
Ah!
So we're now on to my pick for number four in these DIY beginner's toolkit, and that is a level. Now, the more you spend on a level, the better quality it's gonna be. And this is gonna be ideal for when you're putting those shelves up. It's nice and square on the wall. There's nothing worse than something hanging squint on the wall. Even use it for putting pictures up. So they come in all shapes and sizes. This is quite a long one. As you can see, hard to get it in the shot. This is actually what they call a boat level. No idea why, must have used it on boats. But yeah, loads of different bubbles. This one's quite changeable. Loads of different angles on it. Check its horizontal, check its vertical. Loads of uses, as I said, from shelves to pictures to all sorts of bits around the house. So we're on to number 5 on the list, and this comes in loads of different sizes. Bear with me. So, it's a hammer. So we can go very big, very weighty. So this is a 32-ounce hammer, massive. We're not going to start off with that one. Same again, 16-ounce, 450-gram hammer. I'm not going to start off with that one. We're going to go for something like this, and this is a claw hammer. So, the beauty of this is we can hammer things, but we can also pull things out. So it's got a couple of different uses, and as a basic start-off hammer, claw hammer is the one to go for. Ah! So last on the list, number 6, what have we gone for? We've gone for a drill. Why a drill? I've put a set of screwdrivers on the list already. Well, we're going to need a drill because we're going to have to drill holes. And if you're going to be putting shelves up, all that sort of stuff, you're going to need a drill. And the beauty of this is once you've drilled your hole, you can screw your screw in as well. This is what I use on a daily basis. This is my Dewalt XRP brushless 18 volt drill. If you're starting out in DIY, you won't need anything as expensive or as big as this. But if you shop around for something like that in Screwfix or Toolstation, there's always offers on. And so, for instance, in Toolstation at the minute, there's a drill, battery, charger, case for 120 quid. Now, if all you're doing is putting up a couple of shelves a year and that's about it, that'll be absolutely fine for what you need. I would try and avoid things like B&Q specials and Wix specials, own brands and things. They just won't be good enough. Go for something like this. And then the beauty of this is, if you decide you want to take on a bigger project in the future, you've got that battery, and that battery will fit any 18 volt Dewalt or whatever make you go for, Makita or Milwaukee, that will fit their bare units. So let's say your next step was going to be a multi-tool, then all you have to buy is the bare unit and that battery will fit it. So it's incredibly, these systems are all incredibly versatile and infinitely scalable. So you can just have one battery and keep adding bare units to your system. So that's it from Dadskillz today. Those were my 6 picks for your beginner's DIY toolkit. As I say, all those products will be linked below. They won't be the cheapest, they won't be the most expensive, but they're items that I think will see you through the first couple of years of your DIY journey, let's say. So if you think I've left anything out, put it in the comments below. Tell me what your upcoming projects are. I'd love to know. And YouTube have recommended a video for you that will be on screen in a moment. Take a look at that. I think you'll enjoy that as well. So until the next time, I'll see you soon. Cheers.